According to the World Health Organization, 1 in 3 girls has faced domestic abuse before the age of 16.
Of all the cases that do end up getting reported, the survivors of domestic violence have to navigate a toxic and, more often than not, unsympathetic and callous legal procedure.
In 2018, 103,272 cases of domestic violence were recorded according to the National Crime Records Bureau. While specifically gruesome cases often pop up time and again, the media discourse around domestic violence seldom addresses the root cause of this problem.
With the onset of the lockdown, many women have been forced to spend more time in close proximity to the abusers. This is clearly reflected in the marked increase in domestic abuse complaints received by the National Commission for Women. In the 68-day period between 25th March and 31st May, the NCW received 1,477 complaints. This exceeds the number of complaints received between March and May in the past 10 years. There was a 100% increase in the number of cases recorded between the first week and last week of March 2020. The World Health Organization had warned governments about the spike in domestic abuse cases induced by the lockdown. The Delhi High Court, as well as the governments of several states, have addressed the problem and have outlined measures to curb domestic violence. Despite the provisions of helplines, their effectiveness is questionable.
So now, with the lockdown, the words "stay home, stay safe" does not have any meaning for them. This is Madhumita, a volunteer of Aware India, and this is our new series, The Safe Bed Talks. If you are undergoing domestic violence, here are some tips that you can follow to handle the situation. Tip number one, understand that this is not your fault. You are not responsible for another person's behavior, and you are only responsible for your own. Also, understand that you are not alone in this. Tip number two, your safety is of utmost importance. Find a space in your house where you feel safe and ensure that your surroundings are safe as well. Like, for example, during the act of a domestic violence, in case if there is something on in the stove, ensure that the stove is turned off and you leave the kitchen immediately. And make sure any potentially dangerous or harmful items are not left around. Tip number three, see a doctor if you need to, and immediately. As we mentioned, your health and your safety is most important. So due to whatever reason, because of domestic violence, if you have to see a doctor, please do so immediately. And if you are afraid to go to the hospital because of the COVID-19, make sure you at least reach out to your family doctor. And do not be afraid that they might find out. That comes secondary. Your health is a first priority. Tip number four, keep an emergency bag ready. This emergency bag will be something that you take in case you have to leave the home for whatever reasons. This bag will have all your important documents as well as your valuables, that will include cash and jewelry or any other valuables that you may have. Also, ensure that you have a first aid kit in the bag. Tip number five, if you feel that the intervention of a friend or a family can stop the domestic violence, please do so. Always be in touch with your friend or a trusted family member and for your support as well. So there are chances that the perpetrator can try to weaken your support system, and so it is very important for you to be in touch with a trusted family member or a friend. Tip number six, reach out to counseling centers and NGOs. There are many specialists, mental health professionals, counselors and NGO who specifically work for the cause of domestic violence to stop it. You can always reach out, find helplines of these agencies and organizations, and always reach out to them. They will be able to provide support and give you the confidence, and they will also be able to help you figure out what could be the next steps that you can take to move forward. Tip number seven. If you feel that the situation is worse and that you need help, you definitely must call the police. The police will come and they will be able to help you out of the situation. Even if they are not able to physically come for whatever the challenges may be, they will at least be able to guide you to the next steps. Tip number eight, if you feel that you've tried everything in your power and your control to stop the violence and keep yourself safe, but you're still not able to, file a case. reach out to lawyers and protection officers to help you with this. They can help you find, they can help you get a protection order or a residence order, and this will ensure that you are safe in your house and that you will not be removed from your home immediately. These are some tips that you can follow if you are undergoing domestic violence. But stay strong and understand that this is not your fault and you are not alone in this. Have the courage to take the next step to stop this. If you know of someone who is undergoing domestic violence, you can help stop it, and you can also help the person overcome and cope with the situation. Here are some tips for that. Tip number one, provide support and confidence. The chances are that the person undergoing domestic violence is facing a very hard time. So being there and being supportive and encouraging can go a long way. You can also help the person by equipping them or giving them resources like helplines to counseling centers and NGOs that specifically dedicatedly work for this cause. They will be trained and well equipped to handle the situation and to help the person come out of it as well. Tip number two, have very clear records. If there is a person who's confiding in you about instances of domestic violence, make a clear record of it. Make a record of the time, the date, and the details that they are sharing with you. These might in future be evidence or proof in case such a situation arises. Tip number three, interrupt an act of domestic violence. In case if you see or hear an act of domestic violence happening at the moment, interrupt it. This will stop the incident from happening at that point, and it can also stop it from escalating further. For example, if you hear domestic violence happening next door, you can just go ring the doorbell. This will break the domestic violence and stop it from escalation. Tip number four, take a collective stand. If you know of domestic violence cases happening within your resident society, ensure that you, as a society, take a collective stand. Make sure that the message that this is a no tolerance towards domestic violence society. This will definitely discourage the perpetrator from committing acts of domestic violence as well. Tip number five, spread awareness. Even if you don't know anybody who is personally going through domestic violence, spreading awareness can definitely put a stop to this. There are high chances that a person who is undergoing domestic violence visits a pharmacy to get the medications over the counter for themselves. And there are chances that the chemist can identify such a person as well. So putting up posters and flyers with the helpline numbers for the NGOs and counseling centers that can help identify such people and help them can definitely go a long way. These flyers can be put up in pharmacies and stores as well. Always remember that this is not your fault and you are not alone, and that every voice matters. Domestic violence is a disease that has been in our homes for years. We may find a cure for COVID-19, but the only cure for domestic violence is us. The solution is in us. So stay strong and let's put an end to domestic violence. Thank you for watching the video. Please share this to your friends and families, especially those who need this. And if you have any suggestions and feedback, do let us know in the comments as well. For more such informative videos, do subscribe to our channel.